On April 5th, 2024, at 10:23 a.m. local time, more than 30 million residents in the tri-state area were alerted to something unexpected, an earthquake. This earthquake was unusually powerful given the context of New Jersey's geology and fairly infrequent earthquakes, causing the ground to shake for nearly 30 seconds. This shaking accelerated the ground to nearly 10% the force of gravity within a 3-mile radius of its epicenter, but because of the East Coast geology, shaking was felt allegedly as far away as Wisconsin, Iowa, Florida, and Halifax. In other words, more than 100 million people had the chance to feel this earthquake, which, due to its small magnitude, did not appear to cause any notable damage. However, I received numerous reports of items falling off of shelves, which is to be expected from an earthquake of this magnitude. If you are wondering why so many people felt this quake, this is due to rocks on the East Coast being generally quite old, hard, and dense, which transmit seismic energy much better and over longer distances than younger, more porous rock units. So, why exactly did New Jersey's strongest earthquake in 140 years just occur? The answer is the movement of a feature known as the Ramapo fault line. This feature could best be thought of as a series of interconnected fault lines in a zone of weakness in the crust created all the way back 500 million years ago when New Jersey was the site of a shallow sea. It formed due to the same compression which would eventually create the Appalachian Mountains. In geologically recent times, this fault line has been experiencing minor compressional forces from the northwest and southeast. Eventually, sufficient strain builds up on this fault, causing it to rupture and generate an earthquake. In this case, the earthquake occurred on what is known as an oblique left lateral reverse fault. In other words, this quake had both a vertical and horizontal motion component to it, although the motion was largely vertical. In the vertical component, the hanging wall of the fault line moved upwards in comparison to the foot wall. Yet, at the same time, from a top-down view, the left side block moved towards the viewer, representing its horizontal component. If you combine these two vectors, you get the exact motion of the earthquake which struck. And, although I cannot prove this, I must admit the possibility exists that the magnitude 4.8 quake which occurred might have been caused by the nearby Round Valley Reservoir. In other words, it was potentially an induced earthquake. Essentially, any human activity which significantly adds or removes mass from ground overlying or adjacent to a large fault, or any activity which injects fluids that could lubricate faults can induce earthquakes. This can occur due to fracking, wastewater injection, geothermal energy production, mining, and also the placement of dams. For example, of an extreme case of a reservoir-induced earthquake, in 1967 a magnitude 6.5 earthquake struck which was linked to the creation of a dam in India. What was previously a small river there was impounded by a dam and turned into a deep lake, increasing the mass of overlying water on a regional fault line. This placed additional strain on an underlying fault, making it more likely to rupture. However, in my opinion, it is more likely that the dam had nothing to do with the earthquake which just occurred, instead being related to a 4,000-foot-long section of the Ramapo Fault which just naturally ruptured. Faults of a mile or more essentially exist in every U.S. state and territory, meaning that anywhere in the United States can technically experience a magnitude 5 earthquake. However, such quakes are indeed rare in New Jersey. Only 3 magnitude 4 and 2 magnitude 5 range earthquakes have struck New Jersey in its recorded history, with the current quake being the largest since 1883's magnitude 5.3 event. In the aftermath of this quake, more smaller magnitude quakes triggered by the main quake known as aftershocks are likely to occur. Here are the USGS stated odds that various magnitude earthquakes could strike in the vicinity of the aforementioned 4.8 quake by noon local time on April 12, 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.